إنما الدنيا حطام إنما الدنيا حطام
زين. You know what you did? Like they bring food, yeah. And my niece and nephew, they put the plate on the floor, yeah. And I was looking at like, oh, he's gonna remember after picking up the food. And he put it in his mouth, and after like I told him, yeah, oh, he fasted, he dropped it. And he went to the bathroom. Look at that, you know, I'm right next to the driver. That'd be jokes.
Don't think negatively, man.
No, yeah, true.
We so should. Where are we off to today, bro?
We're going to Regents Park to attend a youth, where's it called? What's the name of the seminar?
Yaseen Tours.
Oh, yeah.
Yaseen Tours Iftar.
So it's for young generation to motivate them and give them a talk on this Arafat day. It's Arafat day as well. So people are... When do people go on Arafat day? When do people go on Arafat day?
On the day of Arafat,
yeah.
People fast and people make lots of dua and istighfar.
And
people who are doing Hajj, this is a part of the ritual that they do on the mountains where they make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Yeah, it's part of the Hajj base, bro. It summarizes.
Yeah.
It's not me moving the camera, it's the train. So yeah, don't blame me, guys. The sign is not here. Oh, it's there. No, it's not. I saw the no smoking sign and then I started thinking, is that? That's not ours.
Should you smoke something?
No, never, man. Dad, like, you know, when you, elders have a lot of influence on youngers. So what you do, youngers would be watching you and then they would try to copy you. So if you do something positive, they would do, they would try to follow that as well.
That's true.
Anything
you want to add? If you do slip up with anything, if you make a mistake, remember it's not over. Just because you made the mistake once, it doesn't mean you should keep repeating that mistake. You can get out of it, you can make istighfar, you can repent, you can make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and start fresh. You know, when you make tawbah to Allah, the beautiful thing is that it's as if you never committed that sin. It's as if you never actually committed that wrong. So Allah is Ar-Rahim, Al-Ghafur, and He's the most merciful, and He's the most forgiving. So if you do make a mistake, it doesn't matter how grave it is, just turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He will forgive you all your sins.
Yeah, and those people that repent are one of those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the most. Like there's few types of people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, and the repenters are one of them. If you, as Nur says, slip, don't forget to call upon Him. He hears whoever, doesn't matter who He is, doesn't matter if you're a Muslim, not Muslim, He hears you. So if you call upon Him, He will answer you. He's a strong believer, yeah, and then he takes a lift.
Bro,
he starts taking stairs.
There's no buttons. How are you supposed to go?
I don't know, let's go out. More stairs upon more stairs.
I've had this bag since I was in uni. It's much in my.
Who gave you this?
Huh?
Who gifted you this?
Oh guys,
look at this guy.
We're in Regents Park.
So fresh. Okay, which way are you going?
And Regents Park Masjid is just on the other side.
Okay, and how long would it take us to get there?
Apparently it's going to take us 15 minutes to walk there.
Damn, that is long, man.
I know, subhanAllah. But look at the beautiful sky. To walk all the way through the park. It doesn't look very long, but it's just 13 minutes.
favorite thing about life.
Yeah.
It's the journey, man.
What journey?
The journey from here to the next. I don't know, just to experience it, innit?
The journey from this life to the next life.
Yeah. It's just that you've been given a choice to choose what kind of journey you want to have. Do you want to have a journey where you please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and get to paradise? Or you know, have a journey where you're displeasing and kind of a bad ending. So, yeah.
Would you want to have in the Akhirah? Like in Jannah?
That's what Firdaus. That's what everyone wants, don't they?
Of course. That's what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you should make du'a for whenever you ask for Jannah.
Yeah, exactly.
Because Jannah to Firdaus is the highest.
And then the beauty is that you will get to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself in Jannah.
Yeah, subhanAllah. That's meant to be like the biggest blessing of all. What would you say are some of the steps that we can take, like, to get to Jannah, inshallah?
In this dunya?
Yeah.
Just small, it's just small stuff, man, small steps. You don't have to do like a lot of stuff, like, because you're not a prophet, first of all, you're not like one of the angels, like, you know. Small stuff that you could do to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like it could be like your daily five prayers, or your charity, or sincere charity, your zakah. It could be to please your parents, like helping them when they're in their older age. So these are small steps. It doesn't require much anyways. It's more like your humanity. Yeah. And at the same time, following the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then that's what will please Allah and your, I don't know, to basically fulfilling huququl Allah and huququl ibad.
Yeah, that's true. That's very true, subhanAllah. And you know, everyone has their own strengths. You don't have to be like a scholar. You don't have to be the same as what everyone else is in order to get your rank in Jannah. Even if we look at the Sahaba, they were very unique. They had different skill sets. So one of them, for example, was leaders in battles. For example, Khalid ibn al-Walid. You know, you had scholars and like Ibn Abbas, Ibn Mas'ud, Abu Huraira. Some of them loved the Quran. Some of them loved to narrate the hadith and record the hadith. So each one had their place. And we should keep that in mind, because a lot of us, we try to imitate other people that we see, not realizing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us this uniqueness for a reason. And it's a beautiful thing that we're unique, because in the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that he created different nations so you may get to know each other. And how boring would it be if everyone was the same, right?
Definitely, yeah, man. Yeah. And Islam is there to make it easy for you. It's not there to make it hard. Like, it tells you everything, literally. For example, from your daily life to how to get to next life, what to do for it, like how to get ready for it.
Yeah.
It tells you everything, so that's all you need.
And we'll close it off for now, and we'll be back later. But we'll give you a little look of the park.
Which one are you, Nur? If you had to choose one of them, which one would you choose to be?
This one here.
That one there, yeah, why?
He's on his own. He's alone.
That's what Nur wants, to be alone on his own.
So you have to be different, you have to be.
Yeah. I don't know what I would be, man.
It could be that one, innit?
That's the same thing that you chose right now.
No, I chose that one there.
So I'll be the white one down there.
You want to be the white duck?
Yeah, they're so elegant, innit? So they look pure. Watch out, there's a cyclist. Them. Yeah, they look elegant, and then they are like unique. And
mashallah.
They're not afraid to be on their own as well. So all of them are special in their own way. That's how humans are as well. Humans are special in their own way. Just like the choices they make. Is what would you call it?
Defines them,
definitely.
Yeah, it's true, it's very, very true. The humans are unique and special, every one of them, in their own way.
Yep. Which way are you going now?
Okay, I have no idea which way to go now. It looks like we're gonna get lost. Get lost in Regents Park.
It's gonna be dark soon.
And then we're gonna starve to death.
Not that soon, but yeah, tell them you're from mountains.
We're from the mountains.
How to take starvation, how to take adventure.
That's right.
So, yeah, we know how to.
We've been through this hunger stuff before, man.
Maybe they started football. Let's go from that way.
Playing football.
Yeah, let's go from that way and then we can ask them as well.
Let's go.
Hope so.
Yeah.
Because this says we're like, look, it says we're right next to it, nearly there, but it can't be because look, we're here and there's nothing
there's
here.
No one here. Another bridge. You're gonna cross many bridges in your life. It's just that. What's the next sentence?
How am I supposed to finish it? You'll cross many bridges in your life.
Yeah.
I got one.
Go for it.
There are many bridges you have to cross in life. So make sure you don't ruin the bridges you might have to cross again.
Just like bridges meaning the relationships.
It's like their hearts ain't even red. You can't justify that type of bloodshed. And they could never get inside my head. Too Regents Park Masjid, if you haven't seen it. It reminds me of Masjid Al-Aqsa.
It's my first time being here, man. You've been here before, right?
Yeah.
I've gone on those one of the boats. Oh, that's for babies, isn't it? But yeah. Want to see the masjid. It looks nice. Proper good.
It goes, isn't it?
To Morocco, Tangier. Next month shall be Pakistan. I'm a traveler on these lands. This morning I was chilling out in London.
Nice of you to join us, man. But you joined us late.
We came late, man. We live far. We live too far, but
I live far. We had to go pick up the food.
So, another Yaseen Youth.
Alhamdulillah, I studied banked. Well, kind of. There's a lot of room for improvement.
Where's Nasir?
Nasir's not here, man. He's working. I told him to come, but he didn't come.
Sad.
Yeah. Alhamdulillah. This is apparently he's one of our subscribers. he's feeling a bit shy right now. Look how sick this masjid is, yeah? This masjid is proper nice. They serve food inside as well.
That must be nice, chicken biryani.
Yeah.
Oh, we should go from there, man. We should have got some food from there.
Yeah, we could have, yeah. So if you're ever in Regents Park Masjid or around Regents Park and you're hungry and you need a place to eat and pray, then Regents Park is your place.
Yeah, they close at 6 p.m. Time to pray.
It's time to pray Isha now.
I don't know.